This is India's expenditure on research and development, which is constantly increasing. In 2023, they spent $71 billion, but this is much less than America and China. Its R&D spending as a share of GDP is just 0.7%, compared with 3.6% in America and 2.4% in China. For the fourth largest economy, these numbers are not impressive. This is hindering India's competitiveness on the global stage, particularly in high-tech industries. In 2017, India started manufacturing iPhones and initially made only older or lower budget phones. Over the years, they have expanded their production to include more pro models. Now, they assemble nearly 1 in 5 of their iPhones in the country. By 2026, it hopes to make all the handsets it sells in America in Indian plants, a shift that has irritated President Donald Trump. India's Tata Electronics and Taiwan's Foxconn are the biggest suppliers of India, accounting for about 18% of global iPhone production. It is not alone. Over the past decade, India's electronics industry has grown fivefold. For firms looking to reduce their dependence on China, India is increasingly attractive. Yet, Apple's pivot also shows how far India still lags behind. India only assembled phones locally, but their guts, chips, batteries, and camera modules are mostly made in China. It has a vast manufacturing base, and its domestic firms have climbed rapidly up the value chain. That's made China indispensable to Apple, not just for manufacturing, but as a place where local firms compete with global suppliers. While India has several domestic mobile phone brands like Micromax, Lava, and Carbon, they primarily assemble phones using components sourced from China and have failed to compete internationally or domestically. This reflects a broader problem. While India is rising as a base for assembly, it remains far behind in the kind of innovation that powers advanced manufacturing. India is now the world's fourth largest economy, remains a bit player in cutting-edge technologies. According to the World Intellectual Property Organization, which ranks countries relative to their size and innovation capabilities, India ranks 39th, China is 11th, America is 3rd. In economic terms, innovation describes the development and application of ideas and technologies that improve goods and services or make their production more efficient. A classic example of innovation is the development of steam engine technology in the 18th century. Steam engines could be put to use in factories, enabling mass production, and they revolutionized transport with the railways. More recently, information technology has transformed the way companies produce and sell their goods and services, while opening up new markets and new business models. Innovative new technologies can improve productivity by making work faster, cheaper, and easier. As productivity rises, more goods and services are produced. In other words, it will make you rich. India has become the world's fourth largest economy, surpassing Japan. It still lags behind both Japan and the UK in terms of per capita income, indicating a lower average standard of living for its citizens. If we look at India's vast tech workforce, the country has more open source developers than China, second only to America. Its diaspora leads some of the world's biggest tech firms, including Google, Microsoft, and IBM. Yet, it is largely absent from the race to build leading artificial intelligence. The country is the fastest growing market for ChatGPT. By some estimates, it accounts for the largest share of users. There are some startups unveiled an INDIC, large language model, LLM, capable of conversing in Indian languages. However, according to LM Arena, a benchmarking website, no Indian model features among the top 200 LLMs by ranking. In 2024, India attracted just $1.2 billion in private AI investment, placing it 12th globally. In America, the figure was $109 billion, and in China, $9 billion. Indian drug maker companies supply much of the world with generic drugs, but have produced few original ones. In semiconductors, India is home to around a fifth of the world's chip designers. Yet, it has a few large chip firms like HCL Technologies, Tata Elxsi, Bharat Electronics, and Vedanta, with significant investments and expansions in chip design, manufacturing, and supply. Although, talent is not a problem. The country trains large numbers of coders and engineers, and its universities, including the elite Indian Institutes of Technology, train talent for the world, but publish little world-class research, and not one Indian university ranks among the world's top 100 for scientific research. According to the IMD World Talent Ranking 2024, India has dropped to 58th globally, from 52nd in 2022. For a country that wants to challenge China as a high-tech manufacturing hub, there are three main problems that hold India back. Its firms invest too little in research, universities and labs rarely turn ideas into products, and entrepreneurs lack incentives to pursue risky, long-term innovation. Let's start with the firm. In the world's most innovative economies, the private sector leads R&D spending, typically accounting for around two-thirds of the total. In India, it contributes just over a third. Among the top 2,000 corporate R&D spenders globally in 2023, only 15 were Indian companies, together investing about $5.9 billion. For comparison, Google alone spent $45 billion that year. Why are Indian firms unwilling to spend money? The core problem is not a lack of funds or talent, but a mindset issue more than anything else. Firms actually think they're investing a reasonable amount in R&D, but by global standards, they are barely spending at all. Indian industry invests only 0.3% of its sales in in-house R&D, far below the world average of 1.5%. In America, the figure is 8.8%. In China, 2.1%. They also argue that the market doesn't need it, or that the market cannot afford anything new. But research shows people are often willing to pay a premium, such as 10 to 30% more, for a product or service that is significantly better or different. The public sector performs better. Indian academics are prolific. By number of publications, they rank third in the world. But India has been losing academic talent to America for decades. At the famed Indian Institutes of Technology, the IITs, over 60% of the top 100 performers migrate abroad, mostly to America. Nearly a third of international students there are from India. This brain drain is a huge problem for the intellectual market. The system and society discourages risk-taking and rarely rewards breakthrough ideas. In 2024, India filed only 85,000 patents, which were just 8% of the 1.6 million applications filed in China and 14% of the 590,000 in the United States. In the past decade, India has spent between 4.1% and 4.6% of its GDP on education. China's spending on it as a share of GDP may be roughly similar, but its GDP per person is five times that of India's. In the past decade, China has splurged on lucrative research grants and one-off bonuses to lure back Chinese academics from the West. India lacks the rupees to match China's academic charm offensive. In 2023, the government launched the Anusandhan National Research Foundation, or ANRF. It plans to spend $6 billion over the next few years to boost research across universities and labs. Roughly 70% of the funding is meant to come from non-government sources, including private firms and philanthropies. But the real issue is structural and corruption. People don't know the ANRF money flows through the right channel or it's going into pockets. India's startup sector, often held up as a bright spot in the Indian economy. India's startup ecosystem ranks third globally. With over 100 unicorns, it offers rich investment opportunities for foreign investors. They mostly focused on quick delivery apps, fintech, e-commerce, and edtech, replicating successful Western business models. In contrast, Chinese startups are pouring money into electric vehicles and batteries. The criticism is not baseless. According to Traxon, a research firm, Indian deep tech startups, those working in fields such as AI, computer vision, and robotics, total funding of just $9.7 billion. That accounts for barely 10% of total startup funding in India in that period. Chinese deep tech firms raised $98.6 billion. India's AI push has also leaned heavily on the domestic market. Policymakers often speak of making AI work for India. That seems sensible. Many of the country's challenges, from healthcare to education, could benefit from AI. But a narrow domestic focus may also limit ambition. India needs a big bet mindset. Developed economies are betting on AI as a powerful engine for economic growth. Although all these reasons are dominant in India, yet in 2018, India invented UPI, Unified Payments Interface. No other country had a successful UPI innovation like India had. Basically, UPI is a real-time payment system that allows for instant fund transfers between bank accounts using a mobile device. It has expanded access to digital payments for a wider population, including those in rural areas and small businesses. And, more importantly, UPI transactions are traceable, promoting transparency and accountability in the economy, which can lead to better governance and resource utilization. The effectiveness and large-scale impact of UPI can also be judged by the fact that it has become the most common medium of transactions in India, as close to 490 million individuals and 65 million merchants are now using it. The system is also expanding its presence globally, with the UAE, Singapore, Bhutan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, France, and Mauritius being its latest adopters. India has heard all these stories and criticisms before. Previous waves of digital change, from the internet to the smartphone, were dominated by American tech firms. India is one of the largest users of products from Google, Microsoft, and Meta. These shifts did give rise to some local champions, mostly in e-commerce and fintech. But few of these companies have expanded abroad. For a country that has ambitions to move up the innovation ladder, it must make more efforts.